Hey, what's going on, everybody? My name is Mike, also known as BereghostGames, and welcome to Mafia 2. This is a new Let's Play that I'm going to be starting on my channel after I've just completed my other Let's Plays of Bully, Scholarship Edition, and The Saboteur. This is my next Let's Play. I have actually already beat this game. I did it last year or so, and I gotta say that this has got probably one of the most phenomenal storylines I've played in a very long time. It's one of those storylines where, like, when I played this game, I couldn't let it go. I just had to keep playing and playing to see what happens next. It's just that good, and I wanted to share it with you guys. Regardless if it gets a whole lot of attention or not, it's a couple years old, but I think it's well worth the Let's Play. So let's just jump right in here to... let's see.
My name is Vito Scaletta. I was born in Sicily in 1925. That little guy's me. I was standing there with my parents and my sister Francesca in front of our old house. I don't really remember too much about the old country, except that we were pretty hard up. And then one day my father decided it was time to move away. From Sicily, across the ocean, to start a new life in America. Seen anything as fantastic as Empire Bay. It was beautiful. On the other hand, I'd never seen anything filthier, more disgusting than our new shithole of an apartment. The American dream. More like a nightmare. My father started working at the port for the guy who arranged our immigration. It was backbreaking work, and the little money he made mostly went towards booze. Eventually, my parents sent me to school. I had to learn English. I sure as hell wasn't gonna do that in a neighborhood full of Italians. That's where I met Joe.
Come on, Vito, hurry it up. We ain't got all night.
Over time, Joe and I got to be best friends. And since we were both poor and there wasn't much work around, shit, we started a little business of our own.
Freeze! Police! Stop!
Vito, this way! Throw me to bed!
Stop! Let her shoot!
Shit.
Okay, you bastard. Spread your legs.
Fuck.
Put your hands on
him. Well, that one time it didn't work out so good. The year was 1943. America was at war, and the army was looking for guys who spoke the language to help with the invasion of Sicily. I was 18, and anything seemed better than jail. Who says you can't go home again?
Operation Husky. I was assigned to the 504th Parachute Infantry. On the 11th of July, we were supposed to be dropped over the southern coast of Sicily, but we got hit by flak and had to bail out, way behind enemy lines. Only three of us made it. If it wasn't for the local resistance, we wouldn't have had a chance. So when Mussolini soldiers came into the town and started rounding everybody up, we decided to return the favor.
Se nessuno parla, quest'uomo morirà.
Ain't gonna happen, buddy. We're gonna put him down.
All right, Scaletta, take the shot.
Allora, traditori, pensavate di poterci prendere in giro?
All right, let's get in there, boys. Come on now. Holy hell. That just knocked me on my ass.
Corporal, this guy's saying his one troop's headed this way.
Well, let's get in there. Come on now.
Then find the prisoners. We're gonna need every man we can get.
I think I could have climbed in the window myself, partner, but thank you very much, Private.
Ain't getting through this one.
Have one of those. Oh, crap. That didn't go as intended.
Scaletta, you alive?
Yeah, just about.
Well, then get off your ass and let's move it.
Grab all the ammo you can
Whoa.
Carry.
Oh.
This might be our last
Whoa.
Chance.
Yeah, shit.
Anything else in here? Come on, stick your head out, boy. Stick it out. I got some. Oh, what the heck? I missed. Come on now. Just what I wanted. I'll just shoot him in the nether region.
Prisoners upstairs. Clear the second floor. Scaletta, you take point.
Uccidete gli ostaggi!
Ti nascondi, minchione!
Anybody else in there I need to be worried about? Whoa!
Got him. The door's going up. Kick it in.
Arrenditi, o gli faccio saltare.
Let him down. Let him down. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Okay, we're not going that way, boys. Like gotta find another way.
Come on.
Anybody else?
Shit,
that was close.
This balcony isn't gonna work.
No kidding. Oh! No!
Get inside, Scaletta! You're gonna die out there!
Where's the gun at? Oh, there it is.
Get on that machine gun!
Oh my gosh, these guys are like frickin' ants. They're coming out everywhere. Oh, crap. Come on, guys, get out of here. Get out of here. I got this. Oh crap.
Dicevo al mio amico di stare attento.
Fregatene di fare attenzione, fai ciò che ti è stato detto!
Cacetto, un congè quando samaritano mi cucina.
Ma chi è quello? Lo conoscete?
Lo conoscono tutti. Don Calò è un uomo d'onore.
È uno stupido trucco degli americani, non ditemi che gli credete.
No, è davvero Don Calò. Ogni tanto dovesse ascoltare i consigli di noiacci del boss. Ci rendiamo.
Sapete che potete affidarvi di me. Che ne dite, eh?
Don Calò, the head of the Sicilian mob. An entire garrison of troops surrendered that day. Why? Because he told them to.
That's a man with power right there. Chapter 2 of our lives. Home, sweet home, Alabama. 2 years later, Empire Bay.
Later, the Nazis put a bullet in me. I was in the hospital for a bit. Then I got a month's leave so I could go home. At least for a little while.
Vito! Over here!
Joe!
Hey! Welcome home, buddy.
How'd you know?
I got my sources. Come on, let's take a ride.
Nice car.
Comes with the territory. I know you're itching to get home, but first, let's get a beer.
Yeah, sure.
So, winter wonderland here.
There it is. Empire Bay. Tell the truth. You miss it?
Hey, there's a bear shit in the woods. Not like this place ever done me any favors, but anything's better than a foxhole. What's with this shitty weather?
They're saying this is the coldest winter on record. Papers say it's gonna keep up like this for weeks. Don't worry, though. A drink will warm you right up. How long's it been since we had a drink together, Vito? 2 years?
Almost three. Tony Sicelli's party, right?
Come on, Vito. Come on. The last drink we had together was right after your romance funeral. Right before you shipped out. You remember.
5 minutes. We're already talking about my deadbeat father. Can we change the subject, please?
So tell me, pal. What was it like over there, anyway? I kept reading the papers to see what was going on. And you know how much I hate reading?
Yeah, I know.
You guys kicked Mussolini's ass, right?
Sort of. We had a little help from a guy named Don Calò.
No shit. Don Calò. I heard of him.
Really?
You bet. I know guys like him over here. Wise guys. You work for them, you're set. You fuck with them, you die.
Nice to see you've been busy.
Yeah. And I heard you got a medal, right?
From old man Patton himself.
Whoa, so you're a real war hero, huh? And then what? You screwed a couple of Sicilian broads and came home?
Yeah, right.
The old country. Over here, you can screw anything with a heartbeat. No one gives a shit. What a country. Here's to the US of A and to having you back home.
Salud.
Salud. Chin down. So how come you're back? They let you out early for good behavior?
I took a bullet a couple months back, spent some time in the hospital, and now I'm on leave.
Wait. You mean you gotta go back?
What'd you think? The war ain't over yet.
You don't wanna go back, do you?
Of course not, but what can I do?
1 minute. Wait right here.
Hey, Giuseppe. It's Joe. Remember last week, you know, the guy's name is Vito Scaletta. Thanks, Giuseppe.
What's up, baby?
I'll see you later. Okay, listen up. It appears that your injury is much more serious than it first appeared, and the doctors say you can't fight no more.
What? Oh, whoa, whoa, did you just...
Like I said, I know people. You get all the official paperwork tomorrow. When it comes to the right stamps and signatures, it's just a question of money.
You're kidding me, right? Isn't that a bit risky? It's me that could end up in a slammer, you know? And how am I gonna pay for it?
I got it covered. Think of it as a welcome home present. And don't worry, the documents will be clean. Trust me.
Well, thanks.
You're welcome. Como no frade, you're like a brother to me. Now you can start thinking about what you're gonna do next.
Sure. But first, I gotta go home.
All right, you wanna ride?
No, thanks. I wanna walk around a little, see what's changed since I've been gone.
No problem. Say hello to your sister for me. Come see me tomorrow. We got a lot to talk about.
I can't believe you just got me out of the service. Thanks again.
No problem.
I'll catch up with you tomorrow.
I think she's eyeballing me. You eyeball a bee, dog? Oh, I love these old school cars.
Ooh, all right, thanks. Get the change.
But the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place
to go, let it snow. Let's see, audio. We want to have, I know you guys are going to want the, let's see, where is it? Game setting, subtitles on. I know you guys are going to ask for that. There you guys go. Subtitles are on.
Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Man, it doesn't show signs of stopping.
Let him go! Yeah, we'll be right back.
The lights are turned on. What are you guys doing?
Let it snow. When we finally kiss goodnight, how our fate falls out of the storm. But if you really hold me tight, all the way home.
Whoa, the heck was that? Go upstairs to Mama's apartment. Apartamento.
Hi, Mama. I'm back.
Vito. Vito, my boy. My boy's home. I thought I'd never see you again. Francesca and me, we wait.
Hey, sis, what's going on?
We wait for you.
Yeah.
Sit down, sit down. You must be hungry, Vito. Francesca made you a special dinner. Zuppa di pollo. It's good for you.
Wow, looks good, Frankie.
It's a shame your papa didn't live to see this. He would be so proud, Vito.
Yeah. Sure.
Vito, you know better.
Sorry, Mama, sorry.
Benedice, Signore, in ciò che la tua volontà. Siamo al cielo, provvedimi per le precise più in mano.
You should get some sleep. Your room is just like you left it.
With dog posters on it, huh? Outstanding.
I'll see you two in the morning.
Sleep well, dear buddy.
This ain't gonna cut it. I gotta find a place to stay.
Yeah, we can't be staying in my old room. I guess that's the only clothes we have right now. That'll work.
So you have to go back soon?
Actually, looks like I won't. Joe's taking care of it for me.
Joe, you want to get into trouble again?
Mama, would you rather me go back and get shot again?
No.
Exactly.
No.
Joe probably saved my life.
Promise that you won't get in any more trouble with that, Joe. You know, your papa used to work for this man at the waterfront named Papalardo. He's in the union. You could talk to him, Work hard like you were your pup. Talk to him. Please, promise me you go talk to him today.
Okay, Mama, okay, I promise.
Grazie a Dio.
What if I don't want to work hard like my dad? What if I want to just go do missions and inappropriate things? All right, let's go see Joe. Hey. Hey, it's Mike Monty.
I don't give
I'm
a
sorry.
Damn. I don't care.
We'll get the
you
money.
Gotta sell everything
I promise.
What the hell's going on here?
Vito!
You mind your business,
no.
asshole.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Uh-oh, another famous headbutt.
Come on, Junior. I'm gonna take you to school.
Oh,
come on, bring it then.
Scaring a woman, huh?
Come on, bring it.
Show me what you got.
Vito, please. You're making it even worse.
Oh, he dodged. He can box. Oh. I can box too, homie.
Stop, stop, please. Vito, what are you doing?
Oh, he can box too. Oh, come on, bring it. Bring it.
Please, Vito, this isn't your problem.
Oh, nice. Nice. Oh, oh.
You'll get yourself into more trouble, Vito.
Oh, jeez. Come on.
Stop, stop, please. Vito, what are you doing?
I'm gonna knock him out, that's what's gonna happen. Oh! Down you go.
Ah, fuck this. Yeah, that's right. Get the fuck out of here. You're gonna be sorry. The both of yous.
What the hell was that all about?
I'm sorry, Vito. We didn't want to bother you with this.
Bother me? Bother me with what? Come on, tell me what's going on here, Frankie.
Right before he died, Papa borrowed money. A lot of money from a loan shark. Thinking he'd get a better job and pay him back. We found out right after you left for the war.
How much?
$2,000.
What? Shit.
The worst thing is, this guy wants it all back by the end of this week. Otherwise, the debt goes up again.
I ain't gonna make that kind of money working at the port. Who is this guy?
I don't know. Mama won't tell me. It's okay, Vito. We'll manage somehow.
Don't worry. I'll take care of this. I promise.
Thanks, Vito. Take care of yourself.
$2,000.
I gotta get my hands on $2,000 fast. I bet Joe could help me out.
Yeah, $2,000, that's a lot of money at this time. Okay, let's head to Joe's place. I guess we'll just run there. We don't have a car.
Is it fixed yet?
It's the same as when you asked me 10 seconds ago.
Crying out loud.
What the hell's the matter with you now?
Cold.
Sit in the damn car if you're cold.
What seems to be the problem here?
Hurry up and fix this piece of junk.
It'd get done a hell of a lot quicker if you quit nagging me and give me a hand.
I am not nagging you.
Yeah, huh? Well, if you're as good with a wrench as you were with your mouth, we could have this damn thing fixed already.
Oh. You don't talk to a woman that way. Yeah, get up. Get up. Let's see you run your mouth some more. There you go, ma'am. I don't even know where she went. Alright, I took care of your husband for you.
Alright, let's go up to Joe's place. Where is his place? I'm assuming it's one more floor up.
Excuse me, ma'am. Do you know where Joe Barbaro lives?
To the right of the stairs. And tell him that racket last night has to stop. If he don't like it, he can find another place to live.
This is bad,
huh? We ain't getting out at all. Come on in, let's talk.
You disgusting pig.
I picked up these broads on my way back from the store. I've been waiting. All right, girls, that's it for now. I got business. Stop by tomorrow, okay? We'll pick up where we left off. Chop, chop.
Come on, Joey. Why do we have to stop when we can all have fun?
The fun's over, baby. Later, I said. Me and Vito here haven't seen each other for a long time. We got a lot of catching up to do.
Looks like you're doing okay, Joey boy.
Not bad. I tell you, that little Spanish broad is fucking wild. So how'd it go at home?
Good. Mama wasn't thrilled when I mentioned your name, though. Now, you know how she is. She wants me to get a straight job.
You're gonna look for one?
I don't know, but I sure as hell ain't gonna make the same mistake my old man did. I gotta pay off his debts, then get back on my feet and get my own place. I need to make some real money. Punching the clock ain't gonna cut it.
Hey, you can stay with me as long as you need to, and we'll find you a job where you can make good money without killing yourself, all right?
Music to my ears. Right now, I'm living off the 20 bucks the state gives me every week.
I know lots of people who pay well for a risky job, so to speak. I'm sure I can line something up for my oldest friend. The working man's a sucker, that's for damn sure.
You said it.
Okay, step one. I gotta introduce you to Giuseppe so we can pick up them discharge papers. Let's go.
Roger that.
You made enough cash for all this in the last 3 years?
More like the last 3 months. I barely had time to furnish the place.
3 months? Holy shit.
You just gotta know the right people, and you're all set, because you know me. So you thought about what you're gonna do now?
You said you were gonna introduce me to that guy Giuseppe.
I meant, you know, the big picture. When you was over there, didn't you think about what you was gonna do when you got back?
Well, not really. Well, besides the usual, you know. Find a nice girl, settle down.
Whoa. Hey, there's gonna be plenty of time for that shit later. Right now, I'm gonna make sure you live a little.
Hey, thanks again for that thing with the discharge papers.
Hey, all I do is make a phone call. You can thank Giuseppe when we go pick him up.
Hey, you think I could,
What? Drive, Vito? The roads are icy. You ain't never drove a car before.
Joe, I was driving almost the whole time I was over there.
Yeah, but this ain't no tank, Vito. This is one of the nicest cars money can buy.
I didn't drive a tank. I drove a Jeep.
What the hell's a Jeep?
It's, never mind. You gonna let me drive over?
All right. Here's the keys. Just be fucking careful. All right, when it's cold as fuck outside, you gotta give it a little more gas than usual. That's the pedal over there on the right.
I know, Joe, I know.
Okay, now make a right here. Then just go straight for a while.
Roger that, we got it.
Hey, whoa, slow it down a bit. No need to get pulled over for no reason.
Oh, that's right. I forgot. In this game, you can actually get pulled over by the police for speeding, so we've got to be careful.
Hey, Vito, you know what time it is?
It's daytime. How the fuck should I know?
It's time for you to get your own fucking car.
Yeah, I'd love to if I can afford one.
Who says you're gonna pay for it?
Really? You gonna buy me a car now? I hope you buy me a car, because I sure as hell can't afford one.
They really taught you to drive over there. At least something good come out of it.
Excuse me, guys. I guess we're pulling in back here.
Ooh, get a load of that bait.
Nice. That's a 42 Jefferson.
Beautiful car like that, it'd be a shame to smash the window. You should grab yourself some lockpicks over at Giuseppe's. Welcome to Giuseppe's General Store, a thief's paradise. You name it, he's got it. He even sells phony gun permits and discharge papers for guys tired of getting their asses shot off. Hey, Giuseppe, I brought
Hello,
you a new customer.
He's straight up, right?
Yes, sir, all the way. This here's Vito, my oldest friend. This is Giuseppe, the best safecracker in Empire
Retire,
Bay.
Please. How are you? Papers for you?
Yeah, they are. You got them finished already?
It was a pain in the ass, but sure, they're done.
Well, thanks. This really gonna work?
Nobody from the army will bother you again, trust me.
You see? What I tell you? Here's the money. Take your papers, Vito.
We need a set of lockpicks, too.
That we do. And guess who's paying for them?
Set of lockpicks. $7. I'll take them.
Grazie. But you can test it right now. Here, take this lock. You just need to insert the pick into the lock and lift all the pins. You use the wrench to hold the pins one by one. When all of the pins are set, just turn the wrench and the lock shall squeeze.
Ah,
damn it.
There we go.
See you around, Giuseppe. Say Benedico.
Easy, huh?
Don't worry. You'll get the hang of it. I do it all the time when I lock my keys in the car.
Wasn't too bad. We're professional lockpickers now.
Okay. You still feel like snagging that car?
You kidding me? Absolutely.
Well, here's your chance.
All right, let's lockpick it then. There we go.
Possible Grand Theft Auto.
Oh, hell no. Crap.
Step on.
Roger that. Vehicle theft in progress. In pursuit of suspect.
Hey, well, it's not over yet. Lose him. Quick.
10-4.
This vehicle is wanted by the police. Oh boy, we gotta get the hell out of here. Oh, we're losing the police. We're losing them. We're losing them. We're good.
All right. Looks like we lost them. So how do you like the car?
Not too bad. Think I'll keep it.
All right, let's go find ourselves a body shop. They provide the kind of services.
Oh!
Hey, that don't sound cheap.
Don't worry about it. I got it covered. Just find any body shop. I know the guy who runs it.
Well, we're definitely going to need a body shop now after that little incident there. I get my own car and I crash it.
Here. Park right here in front of the garage door. Okay, now honk your horn.
Hey, good afternoon.
There we go. Oh man, look at the front of that thing now. I beat the heck out of it.
How can I help you?
Let's change the plates.
A license plate. For you, no problem.
Oh, check it out. We can customize the plate. Oh, this is awesome. All right, here.
There you go.
Oops. Well, we just, I guess we're done customizing it. Let's see, let's browse the shop. What else we got here? Repaint, basic tuning, repair the car. How much? Nice. Change the rims.
Are you looking for a new set of wheels? Take your pick, Val.
Oh, oh, look at them white walls. Ooh, those are pretty fancy. If this is on Joe's dime, then let's just go ahead and fix the whole car up then. Let's browse our colors.
You can paint it any color you like. Take your pick.
Ooh, man. Oh. That red right there is pretty nice. What else we got? Basic tuning? Let's tune the engine. Listen to that bad boy.
Sorry, pal. No can tune.
Aw. Well, that sucks. Alright, well then I guess we're done then.
Bring it by anytime.
We got a new paint job and some new plates and rims. Thanks, Joe.
Alright, next you should introduce yourself to Mike Bruski. He probably have some work for you.
All right, where is he?
He owns a junkyard over in Riverside. You can't miss him.
Hey, who's that guy back there?
What guy?
The guy at the body shop.
Oh, Tommy. He's my buddy's nephew. He's kind of quiet, but let me tell you, the kid's some hell of a dancer. Saw him at the old dance hall in Oyster Bay a couple of weeks ago. He had all the broads going nuts.
Do I detect a hint of jealousy?
Oh, are you kidding? I don't need no dance moves. I got charm, my friend. Here, I'll give you some of my lines, so maybe you won't have to spend so many nights with Rosie Palm and her five sisters. Hey, here's one. Hey, is that a mirror in your pocket? Because I can see myself in your pants.
Oh, jeez. That was pretty lame.
Now, here, I got another one. If I could rearrange the alphabet, I'd put you and I together.
Oh, come on.
That one was pretty lame, too.
Oh, this one never fails. Hey, baby, that's a nice outfit. It'll look good crumpled up at the foot of my bed in the morning.
And this works for you.
Oh, here's a good one. Hey, do you know the difference between sex and conversation? No? You want to go back to my place and talk?
You got problems, you know that?
Yeah, I don't know if these pickup lines really work.
Why don't we go back to my place and play house? Me the door and I'll slam
you. Oh, that was bad.
Yes, hey, it was.
When you measure seven soft, you don't have to be good with words. You get my drift?
When you measure seven soft, wow.
Hey, take it easy where the road curves up here. A couple of weeks ago, some guy went right through the damn guardrail and drowned it in the water.
Well, thanks for the warning there, buddy. Even though the car does slip a little bit in the snow.
Okay, now make a right here. Alright, almost there. Make a right up here.
There's a gun shop. We need to get me a piece.
That's Mike's junkyard, there. Just drive through the gate.
Who's
hey,
here?
Mikey boy, what's going on? Shit, Mike, you could wash your fucking hands once in a while. Now I need a fucking bath.
Hey, I've been working.
Look at the handprint on the shoulder.
Dirty, you know? Besides, I just wiped them off.
With what? The same fucking rag you used to clean the toilet, you filthy fuck?
Put a lid on it. What are you, from the health department, or you want to do some business?
Business, of course. This here's my friend Vito. Vito, this is Mike Bruski. Don't shake his hand. I ain't got that much soap at home.
Nice to meet you, Vito.
Me and Vito go way back. He just come back from overseas and he needs some cash. So I figure he can help with your supply problem. I can vouch for him.
Uh-huh. Okay. Joe told you about our side business, right?
Yeah.
I only want regular cars, nothing fancy. You get a cut of every car. I take as many as I can handle. And don't bring no cops around, okay? They follow you here. I don't know your ass from Jesus. You get me?
Got it.
God damn it, Mike. You put your grubby mitts on my fucking coat. I paid a fortune for this thing.
All right, calm down or I'll stick them up your ass, you sissy.
You know, dry cleaning costs these days.
Jesus Christ.
And who knows if they can even get this filled
out. You shut up. Vito, listen to me. I need a Walter coupe today.
I got a few people looking for parts, but I can't find a car.
Because you don't know where to look. Every time I drive down Hunters, I see one parked by a bar there. I think the place is called the Lone Star.
Isn't that a Moulinan neighborhood? I'll stick out like a sore thumb.
All right, look, I'll give you $350 for it. It's worth the risk, right?
$400.
All right, deal.
Alfredo, come on, let's go. Andiamo. Meantime, I'll be sending you the cleaning bill for my coat.
Yeah, I'll change my address, you rat prick.
Okay, listen up. This is your maiden voyage, so to speak. So try not to fuck it up, man. Here, Vito, take this, just in case.
Hey, nice. Hey, Mike, you mind if I test this thing out here?
Sure. Knock yourself out.
That's a nice car.
There you go. Aim for that old wreck over there.
Hey, Vito, see if you can hit the gas tank.
Oh.
Did I leave gas in that thing?
There's a Polak joke there, but I'll leave it alone.
Oh, yeah, that reminds me. Fuck you.
All right, that's enough shooting. We got work to do.
All right, let's holster our weapon. Let's get out of here. Get in the car, Joe. Let's get out of here. Oh, it's slippery. Yeah, this snow has real effects here. Oh, we can change the radio station.
It has been a brutal and bitterly cold winter. The Soviet forces have taken the...
All right, go out the way we came in and get on the main highway going west. Don't go back through the city.
I got it. I can read the map.
So how's it feel to be back?
Good. Feel a lot better with some money in my pocket.
Hey, what's the rush? Money don't buy you happiness, you know.
Get the fuck out of here.
I was just fucking with you. Don't worry about the money. This little job is just the beginning. Pretty soon you'll be rolling in it.
So, Sand Island's still the same shithole it was when I left?
No. The place actually ain't too bad now.
Shit. How the hell that happened?
All the moolies flew south for the winter. Of course it's still a shithole, Vito. You've only been gone a couple of years. Gonna take a lot longer than that for that neighborhood to turn around. Them people multiply like rabbits. What are you gonna do?
It's even worse than when we was kids. They even got some kind of gang there now. What's their fucking name? The Beamers, the Boomers, something like that. I don't fucking know.
Oh, that's just fucking great.
Hey, what are you worried about? They're animals. All they do is sell dope and kill each other. They ain't gonna bother a guy like you. And even if they do, that's why I gave you that pistol.
Well, by the way, you're carrying a gun now? What's the deal with that?
Can't do business without it these days. Especially in this fucking neighborhood.
You, really know how to inspire confidence, you know that?
Yeah, but he gave us a pistola. That's all we need. Anybody tries to mess with us, any greaseballs, we'll frickin' whack him, eh?
Take a left up here.
Something? One of these days, I'm gonna buy a house.
Look at this guy. Ain't even back in day and he's too good for his old neighborhood.
Hey, what are you breaking my balls for? I'm just window shopping. It'll be years before I can afford a place like this.
You got champagne taste and beer pockets, my friend. Don't worry, though. I'm gonna help you change that.
Sure hope so, man, because you already bought my first car. You gave me a pistola. You've hooked it up already and you got me out of the army. I'm already in debt to you. I just hope you don't expect any of it paid back, because I'm not doing it. Oh, that guy just slipped on the ice.
It's that cream-colored baby over there. Be careful. Do it quick and get the fuck out of there. Break a window if you have to and go. I'll wait for you back at Mike's.
What if I run into problems?
Then you deal with them. Look, consider this a test.
If you fail, I hear they're hiring down at the factory.
Right, just asking.
Good luck, pal. I see you back at Mike's.
Bust a window if you have to, eh? I really would rather not.
Hey, what the fuck are you doing over there?
Oh.
Oh, shit.
Dang, man! Ooh, this dude can box! Oh! Not as good as me, though. Come on, bring it. Bring it. Come on! Oh! Down you go. Alright, let's bring out the piece. Got a bad feeling about this. Oh crap, here we go.
Hey! Hey, what you doing, motherfucker?
Oh crap. Oh! Oh, I gotcha. Gotcha again. Alright, screw it. Smash the window. Smash it. Smash it. Let's get the hell out of here. Go, 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 go. Come on. Oh, crap, he's behind the dumpster. Time to go. Escape from the bombers. Let's get the hell out of Dodge now. We only had to kill two of them, so... Man, look at the bullet holes in the car. That dude's not going to be happy with that. I had to bust out the window and there's bullet holes all in this car. Man, this is a nice car, though. What about my car? I just thought about that. I wonder if Joey took it back. I sure hope so. It's my only car. Oh, crap, they're following me. Oh, I'm slipping. Yikes, yikes! Oh, I just scratched up the fender. Oh crap, police, police. Slow it down. Oh crap, he's still on. Oh, I'm losing control in the snow. Shoot, they're still on me. We gotta go. And these guys are freaking relentless. Come on, step on it. And let's do a little bit of braking. Oh man, he's like right behind me. Oh yeah! Ha 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 ha! You guys are stuck now. Oh crap. Oh yeah, we got this now. I'm trying to get it to Mike in one piece. Oh, I just don't want to get a ticket either or get pulled over by the police. Slow it down a little bit. I don't want to run into a cop. Almost there. I think the car should be in good shape for him. I got a couple of scratches on the fender and a couple bullet holes and a busted out back window, or front window. Hopefully Mike will be okay with that. I at least got him the car. Yikes! Now I just busted out a headlight. Hope they didn't need that part. I wonder if it'll show the actual damage in this cutscene.
Hey, mission accomplished. How'd it go?
It does. Look at the bullet holes.
Except for the fact that the car belonged to a bunch of moolies who immediately tried to kill me right after you left.
Probably the bombers. Hunters, their neighborhood. Guys like that, you don't have to worry about them. They just hang out on the street, talk shit, steal shit, and smoke dope. Let's see what we got here.
Oh, nice. No stains. Clean.
The lowlife get the money for this. Probably stole it himself. It's nice, though. How much did I say I give you for it again?
$600.
Oh, I like your buddy, Joe. Here's your 400 bucks. Stop by again, okay? We can do some more business.
Yeah, you bet, Mike.
I see you, Mike. I'll stop by again real soon.
All right, boys. See you later.
Here's your 300 bananas. I'm taking my cut as the middleman. Next time, you're on your own.
All right. Thanks, Joe.
Nice.
All right, let's go home. I'm exhausted.
Hey, you brought my car back. Very nice of you, even though it's all dirty now. Alright, let's get out of here. This has been a long day.
We should take the highway, Vito.
I was gonna take the highway, Joe.
Right, you pulled off that job without fucking it up. Nice going.
Yeah, but I almost got my ass kicked. I didn't live through the war just to die in Sand Island.
Hey, that's all part of the deal, pal. Take it or leave it. Besides, it ain't like you're qualified for anything else.
Nah, I guess you're right.
Don't worry about it. It's all gonna be a piece of cake.
Whoa.
What's the story with Bruski?
Mike's a good guy to know. He's a little grouchy, but he's always got a scam going. Deals with stolen cars mostly. Spent some time inside a while back. I heard he used to stick up gas stations back in the day.
You gonna make him pay the cleaning bill for your jacket?
Nah, I'll let that one slide. I do a lot of business with the guy. Plus, he's got one hell of a temper. One time we was at the track and some mitt spilled a beer on his wind ticket. Mike beat the shit out of him till he went blind in one eye. A lousy $10. You believe that shit?
Sounds like kind of a scumbag.
Hey, you just got an out of hand to these people. That Mike's a pussycat compared to some of the guys I've met since you shipped out. You'll see.
Hey, is there a safe place to park around here? I don't want to leave this thing out in the street.
Yeah, that's why you're parking your car next to mine in the garage. The streets are full of criminals these days.
Yeah, the neighborhood ain't what it used to be, huh?
All right, well, let's park our new found beast in the garage. There we go. Let's go to Joe's apartment, why don't we?
If you're hungry, there's some food in the refrigerator. You hungry, Vito? Take whatever you want from the fridge.
Cold beer, bottle of soda, classic ham and cheese. Sure, let's take that. Health has been Oh, there we go. Crash on the kitchen couch? Who puts a freaking couch in the kitchen? Alright, ladies and gentlemen, there's the first episode of our Mafia 2 Let's Play. I hope you guys enjoy it. We're just scratching the surface on the storyline. I promise you, this is a phenomenal storyline and great game. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and we'll see you guys next time.